Hi everybody! This tutorial is part of a super fun collaboration with several of my YouTube friends. We've all made step-by-step tutorials for the creations you see here. All of these projects were achieved with the help of Wilton Fondant Molds. You'll really enjoy all of these tutorials. You can click on the screen now, or you can find the link to the entire playlist below the video. Hi everybody, this is Laura
and Arnie
with Crazy Cool Cakes, and today we're coming to you with another super cute and fun tutorial. Today we're going to be teaching you how to make this adorable little turtle. This is so much fun to make. There's a lot of detail, a lot of very cool techniques that we use in this tutorial, and we're actually going to be using Wilton's Nature Mold, so if you already have this, you can create a lot of the embellishments that are on here. So we hope you guys enjoy this tutorial, and let's go ahead and get started. All right guys, so we're starting with a really pretty leaf green. This is Wilton's leaf green. And you're just gonna take a small ball of the leaf green, and I'm kneading it, and I'm going to get all the cracks and wrinkles out, and I'm gonna shape it into a perfect ball. So make sure you've got your nicely shaped ball. Pick the side that you don't like, and that's gonna be the bottom. Okay, and then all you're gonna do is you're gonna dome the shape of the ball. So you just start to gently press down. You don't wanna squash it too much. The sides you do wanna press down towards your table. So just be gentle with it. Use the palms of your hands. And I'm turning and lowering at the same time. That way the edges go towards my tabletop. You wanna just form a really cute turtle shell. And you do want the bottom part to be nice and flush with the table. Squash it down till you feel you've achieved a really nice turtle shell shape. I'm gonna lift this up and show you the sides. See how you can see a fine line around the edge? All right, so what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna prepare the area where the neck and the head are gonna go. So as you all know, I love my Sculpey tools. You can find the link to the set that I use underneath this video in the description box. And I actually use the handles of my tools quite a bit. So you want to find the thickest part, and they're all the same shape. So just find the thickest part of the handle. And I'm going to make a dent into the part of the turtle shell that I've chosen will be the front. Okay, so this will be the front of my turtle shell. And I'm gonna take the thickest part of the handle and just press it inward. Press in and then just spread open. You can see a dent starting to form there. And we're only gonna need this little area to be about a half an inch wide. So this is more than enough room here for our little turtleneck. Can you see that there?
Mm-hmm.
All right, now we're gonna start making the super cute little turtle's neck and head. And for this, I've made a really pretty pastel electric green. So this is Americolor, baby?
Yeah.
Americolor's electric green, but just a little bit. So I've already got the right amount of gum paste for my turtle shell size. Just roll it, get rid of all the cracks and wrinkles. And then you're going to roll this into a teardrop shape. So now that I've got all the cracks and wrinkles out, go ahead and place it on your tabletop, and you're going to, if you look carefully how I'm holding my hand, I'm not flat or parallel with the table. I'm forming like a V shape. And this is what forms teardrop shapes or cone shapes. So you wanna make a long teardrop or cone shape. Okay, just like that. Okay, so here's my nice long teardrop shape. With your finger very carefully, press down just the neck part. You don't want to flatten what will be his little head. He or she, you decide. Yeah. Totally up to you. I think mine's a boy, but I'm not too sure yet. Okay. So there is the right size. Pinch this part. Now what you're going to do is take a toothpick and some cutters. Make sure they're pink or else it won't work. Okay. And you wanna cut it a little bit more than half. You're gonna use the size that's a little bit bigger than half. And you want the toothpick to be going into the head. So I'm gonna shove the bottom part in here and just test it out to see exactly where I want the toothpick placed. So carefully place the little turtle head and make sure you're not denting the head. So from this view that my husband is giving you, you can see at what angle the toothpick will have to go. So I'm gonna remove this, and I'm going to, well, let's switch places, baby, so you can give him a good shot over here. I'm gonna keep my eye on the angle of the head, and this is exactly where you wanna place the blunt end into the shell. Make sure you're putting it in straight. Okay. You want it angled upwards, so that way when you add the head and the neck, the head isn't gonna wanna be hanging down. So that's why we're putting the toothpick pointing upward. Then you're gonna take some edible glue and your brush. If you don't know how to make edible glue, be sure to check out our tutorial. And make sure that you're using a brush with a really cool handmade donut or cupcake by yours truly. Again, if you're not, I can't guarantee that this tutorial will work. So if you wanna purchase your own super cute paintbrush holder, and it comes with a free brush, you can check out the link underneath the video to my Etsy shop, and you
I
can
say,
purchase.
Don't even take the risk.
Yeah, just buy my product. All right, so I've got glue on. Again, remember we pinched the very little end of the neck here, so we're gonna shove that underneath. And now you're going to gently, can you see?
Mm-hmm.
You're gonna gently place the head and push back towards the turtle shell.
Ouch.
Okay, use your fingers and make sure it's nice and flush. Squash everything but the head. And now we're gonna start to shape the head. So you wanna lower the head a little bit. Look at it from the front and make sure that it still looks really cute, nice and round. And also if you wanna make the gum paste that we make, you can also find a tutorial on that, how to make gum paste. Okay, and if you can see the toothpick, then you can shove the gum paste back to hide the little toothpick. And just push it back. Remember, you're the boss. You make the gum paste do what you want it to do. Don't be like, oh, it's not working. No, you make it work.
You work it.
Yeah, you work it. Force it. You make it do what you want it to do. So there you can see I shoved the gum paste all the way back, and you cannot see the toothpick anymore. All right, so there is our super cute little turtle head. Now, while the gum paste is nice and soft, let's give him a cute little smile. So we're gonna use our little smile maker, and this is part of a Wilton set. I love this for making cute little smiles, so you can find the link underneath the video as well. I'm gonna use the smaller. There's a big one and a small one, so I'm gonna use the small one. And you wanna make a cute little smile. Just hold it gently. Push it in. Make it as wide as you want. Isn't that cute?
Super cute.
Take your medium-sized ball tool from your Sculpey tool, and we're just gonna make two small dents for where the eyes are gonna go. We're not gonna add them yet. We're gonna give the head a few minutes to dry before we start messing with it. So I think that the more separated the eyes look, the cuter they look. So let's just make one little dent here at the top. That's just so we'll know where it goes. Can you see that, baby?
Mm-hmm.
And another little dent up here. Kind of looks like a little bookworm right now.
Yeah.
Okay. And again, if you messed up the shape, just you put it back how it was. Cute, huh?
Mm-hmm.
All right, now let's make the little turtle fins, feet. What do they have? Flippers?
Flippers.
All right, guys, so what I've done is place my little turtle body on a little piece of parchment paper just to make it easier for me to move around. And now we're gonna go ahead and make four little flippers, as we found out, okay? And a little tail. So the little balls for the flippers are gonna be just a little bit smaller than the size of the head. So we're gonna make one, and then the other three will be done the exact same way. So just knead and roll into a ball till you get rid of all your cracks and wrinkles. Okay, roll into a perfect little ball. Place it on your tabletop. And again, remember how I showed you how to angle your hand to make a really cute teardrop. And you don't wanna make it too pointy. We're gonna give them nice, cute little plump flippers. So go ahead and make the other three the exact same length and size. Okay, so now we have four little teardrops and they're all pretty much the same size. And what you're gonna do now is you're going to semi-squash, not completely flatten. Take your fattest finger, mine happens to be the middle one, and then just press it down. Okay. And what I'm doing is, again, just like we did the turtle shell, the edges, press them down towards your tabletop so that it's nice and flush towards the table. Okay, fat teardrop. So do the same thing with the other three. And we want the flippers to curve back. So you're gonna take, this will be the front, of course, this is the back. Take one of the flippers and then curve it so that the little point of the flipper is pointing back. So this part here will go underneath his body and this will be pointing back. And then the part that's gonna go under the body, go ahead and just squash it down so it's nice and flat. Okay, this is gonna be the left flipper. So curve it backward so that that little flipper is pointing towards the back, just like that. And again, the part that's gonna go under the body, squash it down. These are the two little back flippers, so let's do the same thing. Okay, so now let's test it out. So we can see where we need to put glue, and you don't need a lot of glue. So these little front flippers, one will go here, the other one will go here. Okay. Make sure they're the same distance from the neck. You don't want to have one.
You mean equidistant?
Equidistant. So that's how they're gonna be positioned. That'll look cute a little bit like that. And like that, okay? So now all we're gonna do is just press it down a little bit so you can make the dents on the little flippers and you'll know exactly where to add glue, okay? So carefully lift your turtle, remove the flippers, and now take your edible glue. And let's just put a little bit of glue only where we need it, and you don't need a lot of glue, just enough to make it tacky. Remember, the more glue you add, the longer it's gonna take to dry. And what I'm gonna do is put my little flippers, and I'm sorry if I'm out of the shot here for a second, but just bear with me, okay? First, let's do these two. See how easy that slides and moves on the parchment? That's why I love working on parchment paper. And then this one, lift up his little butt. That goes right there. And this goes, lift it up, right there. And then press the body down. And make sure, look at your little flippers from up here and make sure that they're pointing in the same direction, that they look uniform. How does that look?
Looks very cute.
Yeah? Okay, now let's make his little tail. Okay, so take your little pea-sized green ball and roll it into a tiny little teardrop. Nice and cute. Okay, just like that. And then we're gonna want a little part of it to go underneath his body. So all you're gonna do is take the tip of your middle finger and squash the end down. Just like that. Okay, And this flat piece is the part that's gonna go underneath his body. So just take a little bit of glue and put it right on that section. And then just carefully lift your turtle's body and slip it underneath. Just like that. Push it in. And then if you wanna point the little tail up, you can. And then take your little flat edge, my favorite. I don't think we could ever work without this, huh, sweetie? Mm-mm. This is like our absolute favorite part of the...
It's an extra finger.
Yeah. Just like that. Okay. So far, so good. How does that look?
Looks great.
Cute. All right, guys. So now we are going to add his little eyes. So you're just going to roll two little tiny black balls. Add a little bit of glue, not a lot, just a little bit, just enough to make them stick on. Okay, make sure it's a nice ball. And then you want to press it down just a little bit. Same with the other one. I'm gonna squash the top down just a tiny bit. Make sure it's nice and snug in the little holes that we made. Okay, now because I was touching black, I'm gonna wash my hands because now we're gonna use a little bit of the light green for his lids. Okay guys, now we're gonna make little eyelids. So you're gonna want two little green balls, the same light green that we used for the head and the neck. And they are the same size as the eyeballs. Okay, so take one of your little green balls and you're going to roll it into a banana shape. So you're gonna first roll it into a little capsule shape and then each end into a little point. Okay, turn it over. And then make the other end pointy. You wanna get it long enough to where the points on the ends will reach both sides of the eye. I'll show you what I mean in just a second. So once you have this shape, okay, like a little banana, two pointy ends, put it back on your tabletop and then with your finger, just very gently press it down. You want to flatten it. And you don't want to flatten it completely. You still want it to be a little plump. Nice and flat. Okay, so it gets to that shape there. Okay, and let's just test it out to make sure that each end of the lid, there we go, that's exactly what we want. Okay, so all I'm gonna do now is put a little bit of glue on the inside of the lid. And then make sure that you place it to where you cannot see the black ball in the back of the head. Okay, so on there. This is when our little flat end of our medium-sized ball tool comes in really handy. For areas where your fingers just don't fit. Doesn't that look cute?
Mm-hmm.
And I'm gonna turn it around to make sure that I can't see any black from behind. Yep, that's exactly what you want. No black showing from the back. And then let's just go ahead and do the same thing with the second eyelid. Make sure both eyelids look the same. Okay guys, so now we're gonna start making the super cute embellishments that go on the turtle's shell. And I'm using the Nature Mold by Wilton. This is the one that has the little leaves and the branches, the little birds. And we're gonna be using some of the flowers. So we're gonna be using the medium size flower for the larger flower embellishments that go on his back. And I'm gonna show you the easiest way to use these molds. So you're just gonna take a small amount of gum paste, remember whatever color you want. I chose a really beautiful, like purplish wine color, and I made this mixing Wilton's rose with a little bit of purple. And so I just roll it into a ball just to get cracks and wrinkles out. more or less the size that you think you're gonna need. Better to have a little bit more than not enough. And then you just place it in the mold and gently press it down. And then I like to use my rolling pin and I place it in the center and roll one way and then the other way. And this keeps you from actually accidentally lifting it. If you roll from one end all the way to the other, it's gonna stick to your rolling pin and you're going to end up lifting it by accident. Then I like to use my straight blades. You can find the links to these underneath the description box, underneath the video. And make sure your blade's nice and clean. It's good to have a wipe around to clean it. And then I like to just take my blade, make sure it's nice and flat on the mold. And with very fast back and forth movements, I just cut halfway through. And then I flip it in the other direction and cut halfway through. And basically it's just section by section. And that gives me a nice, clean cut. Rub your fingers on the end to make sure there's no little burrs. I can't believe I remember the word. And then you just flip it out. And there it is. Isn't that cute?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that's the medium size. You're gonna need 6 of these. Of course, if you're making a much bigger turtle, you determine how many you need. For the turtle that I'm making, I'm only gonna need 6, so I'm gonna cut out a few more of these. All right, guys, now that we have all 6 of our pretty little flowers cut, I'm gonna go ahead and glue them on right away. I like to put these on the turtle shell when they're still very moist. That way, they're totally flush up against the turtle shell. That way, they very easily conform to the shape. Just a little bit of glue. And this one's gonna go right in the center, right on the top of his shell. So cute. Again, you can put these wherever you want, but this is just a pretty pattern that I thought looked cute. The other 5 are gonna go on the sides. This one is gonna go right to his right. The other one on the left, a little bit of glue. Make sure that they're equidistant from each other or from the neck. The other one is gonna go right in the back, right above his little tail. Cute. And then the last 2 will go right between these 2. The one in the front and the one in the back. So pretty. Okay, so there's all the little flowers already in place. All right, guys, now we're going to work with the smallest little flower in the mold. And for this, just take a little tiny bit of whatever color you want to use for the smaller flower. I'm working with a really pretty burnt orange, and this is made with Wilton's orange and a little tiny bit of brown. And I just press it in there, just a little piece of gum paste. And because it's so tiny, I'm not going to use a rolling pin because I don't want to lift it by accident. Make sure your blade's nice and clean. And for something this small, you want to place the blade flat and work your way, or start, I should say, in the middle, and then go towards you. And then again, start in the middle, and then go away from you. And then if it moves around on you, just kind of pat it back into shape, and then I'm just gonna lift the whole thing. Can you get that, baby?
Mm-hmm.
And then just pop it out. There it is. Cute little flower. I love this one. So I need a total of 11 of these, so I'm gonna go ahead and cut all of those out now. Okay, guys, so we're gonna start adding our super cute little tiny flowers, and the first 5 are gonna be placed on top. I'm gonna start with one right behind the turtle's neck. You just need a very small amount of glue. So we're just pretty much gonna be filling in empty spaces. Then we're gonna do the lower area of the shell. And again, one on each side of his neck, one down here. Use the flat end of your medium-sized ball tool because there's just some places where our fingers don't fit. There's all 11 little orange flowers. Cute. Okay guys, the next thing we're gonna do is add this super cute algae, these growths that grow on turtles' backs or on their shells, and also just add a little bit of character to the little, what did we say they were?
Flippers.
Flippers and the face and the neck. So as you can see, I already have a bunch made. Of course, the easiest way would be to roll out gum paste and just use a piping tip to cut out the circles. But the reason I like to roll out every single one by hand is because I like to give it that really cute domed shape. So I'm just going to show you very quickly how to do this. You just take a very small piece of gum paste, you roll it into a ball. And this is made using Wilton's forest green or any dark green that you'd like. And then you just pat it down. Okay. So that's what one would look like. And so I've already gone ahead and made quite a bit. How much algae you want to add to your turtle is completely up to you. Mine is just completely covered in these little pieces of algae.
Because he spends a lot of time in the water.
Spends a lot of time in the water, yes. So make about 650 of these. No, I'm just joking. I would say
651.
Yeah, I would say what, like a total of
60,
like 50 to 60.
Yeah,
but again, just as many as you want to add. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and start adding some of these to my little turtle fins, and I'm gonna add a total of 6 to the front fins and only 4 to the back fins. Again, you add as many as you'd like, as many as you think will look cute. Okay. And then we do varying sizes. Some big, some medium, some small. Okay, there's the 6 in the front on the other fin. Now we're gonna do a fewer on the back fins. Okay, so there's all the adorable algae on the little fins. How do you like that so far?
Good contrast. I like it.
Cute, huh? Okay, now we're gonna add some in the empty spaces on the shell. So again, totally random, wherever you think they'll look cute. And this gives it a lot of real pretty pops of color on the shell. Super cute. So you can see all the empty spots are gone. Now we're gonna add 10 little pieces on both sides of his neck. So I'm gonna start with one big piece. And again, you put these wherever you want, wherever you think they'll look cute. I'm gonna start right here. And then just whatever pattern you choose on one side, you wanna try and match the pattern on the other side. Cute. All right. So there we go. Now we're gonna add some super cute bright orange barnacles. What do you think so far?
Very cute.
Okay, so we are now starting to create the little barnacles, and for this you're just going to roll a bunch of little tiny balls. I use Wilton's orange, and so I'm gonna go ahead and roll about 30 of these, and then once I have all of these rolled, then I'll show you what to do next. So all you're gonna do now is just take your smallest ball tool in your Sculpey set, and you're going to press the little ball into the gum paste so that it looks like a little donut shape, and then just take a tiny bit of edible glue and put it on the back, and then place it anywhere on your turtle's back. I actually only am going to be putting these on the flowers because I think it makes a really nice contrast up against the dark purple. What do you think?
Very nice.
So just randomly on your large flowers. If you want to put it anywhere else, that's fine too. But again, this is what I have chosen for my turtle's back. And I'm just gonna go ahead and place these all over the flowers. Just here and there. All right guys, so here is our little turtle with all the little orange barnacles on its body. And as you can see, it's just very random, whatever you think looks nice. And now we're going to add some really cute color to his face and to the flowers. So let's go ahead and do that now. We've now finally gotten to what for me is the funnest part, in which is the end, and adding color, hand dusting and painting on color to my toppers. So let me just show you very quickly what we're going to do. And of course, many of you know these are my absolute favorite non-toxic pastels. These are my Mungyo pastels. They're not edible, they're just considered non-toxic. But of course, when we make toppers like these, we certainly don't want them eaten. So if you're gonna be making toppers that are not going to be consumed, you definitely wanna use your Mungyo non-toxic pastels. So I'm just gonna pick the colors that I'm gonna be using, and of course you can find the link to these pastels underneath the video. I'm gonna be using a really pretty light red for the cheeks. We're gonna give them some cute little red cheeks. And then as you can see, my favorite brown, which is almost gone. I have to order myself another set. Real pretty light brown for the eyes and the mouth.
You don't use that one too much, do you?
There's nothing left. It looks like a little bone. And then a really cool, super neon purple, just to give it a little bit of character for the purple flowers. And I'm gonna start first with the cheeks. So I'm gonna get rid of the colors I don't need right now. And these are so fun and simple to use. You just take your pastel and then take your blade, and you're just gonna scrape off just the tiniest amount that you're gonna need. That's about it. That should be more than enough for the cheeks. And then for brushing on blush on my toppers, I like to use a really fine camel hair paintbrush. And of course, you can find the link underneath the video. It's a small set, very inexpensive. And these are my favorite because they are so soft, and so they let you spread the color out really nice. I love these chalks because they scrape off in such a fine, fine powder. So you just want to pick up a little bit and then pat it down. And then let's add a little bit of color to my little turtle's right cheek. You don't want to focus too much on one spot because then you end up making it really like circular and noticeable. Then it starts to look kind of fake. So I'm just picking
up. So you just want to blend it.
Yeah, I'm just blending like how we girls really do our makeup. You just blend a really nice color into your cheek.
Fabulous!
Mm-hmm. My turtle is fabulous. Look how cute that looks.
Really nice.
See, so it's just a little tiny hint of color. Okay, we're not going for the clown look.
Or club look.
Or a club look. Do the same for, yeah. Our turtle doesn't hang out at those places. She stays home.
She's wholesome.
Oh, wait a minute. It's a he.
What the heck? Why does he have makeup on?
He's not going to have makeup. It's just a cute little pink cheeks because he's cute. Look how cute that looks.
He's bashful.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so there's our adorable little pinkish cheeks. Okay, that was using the light red. And then now I'm going to use the light brown. We're going to add some color to the mouth and to the eyes. So just get your really nice... Let's see if I can actually do this because there's like nothing left. I use
Watch yourself
color.
Now.
I use this color so much. Just a little bit. Hopefully my hand isn't blocking. I love that sound. Okay. And then have a wipey and wipe off your awesome blade. And remember, you can find the link to these blades also. Okay, so for dusting color, very fine lines and in certain little areas. I don't like to use the camel hair because those bristles are way too loose. So this is my bundle monster pack. And of course you can find the link to this.
That is a monster set, my goodness.
And it's cool because it's so super inexpensive. And you can find all of these cool brushes that I use all the time. And then we're gonna use the little ball tools here in a little bit for the eyes. So this brush here, for adding color to the mouth and the eyelids, this is the one that has the white tip, okay? And it's very flat. So you're just gonna pick up a little bit of the brown. Not a lot, this is just soft color. You don't wanna give him super dark lips. Just a little bit. And then you're going to insert, of course, in the same direction as the mouth. You're not gonna go like this because then you're gonna color way too much. You wanna actually insert the bristles into his mouth. And then you just lightly dust. See, and the reason I use this brush is because the bristles are flat and it fits perfectly into the mouth. How cute is that?
Mm-hmm. Very nice.
Now check it out. What's really cool about these colors is that if you accidentally get it somewhere where you don't want it, and this happens sometimes with fine lines like this, like the mouth. I don't know if you can tell, but you see how there's a little bit of dark brown right here where I don't want it? Can you see that, baby, in the mm-hmm. video? And what's cool is that it comes off with just a little bit of water. So I just sometimes have a little wipe and I wrap my finger or wrap it around my finger and then you just wipe.
And you're actually using your fingernail.
And I'm using my fingernail, and I'm gonna remove where I don't want.
Oh.
You see? Perfect.
Nice and clean.
Mm-hmm. And these are just little techniques that you pick up, you know, just from working. Now we're gonna add some really cute brown around the eyes, the bottom of the eye, and the lid. So again, just a little bit. And then put the bristles between the black eyeball and the green skin. And this shading just, you know, makes it look not so plain as far as color. Okay, now let's add a little bit of color to the top of the lid.
God, that looks like fun.
That is fun. Maybe one day you'll have to make one and then you can watch this tutorial so you'll know how to do it. That's what you did with the elephant.
Yeah, that's what I did with the elephant. Yeah.
It's kind of cool when your husband watches your own tutorials and learns how to sculpt that way. Because when he's here holding the camera, he's not really learning.
I'm focusing
because,
on other things.
Yeah, he's concentrating on holding the camera, and so sometimes I'll be watching my own tutorials and he won't even remember that we had shot that tutorial because he wasn't even paying attention to what I was doing. And then I also want to add a little bit more just to the back of the lid. Don't do really long strokes, just do small little short strokes, because if you do super long strokes, you start to see streaks and you don't want that. You wanna really just blot. Blot your way to perfection. Okay. This is a lot of fun.
Your favorite part.
Mm-hmm. You don't want to go all the way down to the bottom of the lid, just the upper half. Doesn't that look cute?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so if you notice, the black part of the eyes got a little bit dusty from the chalk. So remember a little while ago I told you how easy it is to clean the chalk off with a wipe or with water. So this is the way that I like to clean up the eyes because I don't like them looking chalky. This is another really cool little brush. Any brush will do in the set, just as long as it has small bristles like this. And so I've got my little spray bottle, and you don't need to videotape this, baby, but I'm just gonna spray a tiny bit of water somewhere on my table.
Mm-hmm.
And pick up just a little bit of water. You don't want it dripping, just damp. And then look at how nice the eyes look after they're cleaned. And the turtle's eyes actually look real now because they're shiny. So now we're wiping off the chalk and then cleaning up the eye. And then at the same time, giving the turtle's eyes a realistic look. And even if I hadn't used chalk, and the eyes hadn't gotten dusty, I still would be doing this with a little bit of water at the very end, just to give him some realistic looking eyes. People always ask me when they look at my pictures, how do you make the eyes so shiny? This is how. You just take a damp little paintbrush. And these really are the best paintbrushes.
You like them a lot.
A lot. Look how pretty that looks.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm?
Very nice.
Doesn't it look real now?
Yep.
Okay.
Came to life.
All right, now using the same brush that we used a little while ago, for the brown, now I want to add a little bit of dark brown to my burnt orange little flowers. And that's just to give them a really nice contrast. So just pick up a little bit of brown. And we're gonna add a little bit of brown right in the center of the flower and then between the petals. And for this, we are going for a dusty look. We wanna have it nice and rustic. I think this adds a lot of elegance and beauty to the turtle. So add some between the petals. And in the center. So we're gonna go ahead and just do the rest of them now. We'll probably speed up this portion of the video. Man, that looks so pretty. Don't you love the way that brown looks on the orange?
It looks great.
I love it. All right, now we're gonna add some super cool bright purple to the centers of the dark purple flowers. And for this, we're gonna use our beautiful brightest purple that comes in the Mungyo set. So just scrape off. That should be good. And so that you don't have to use a different brush every single time. If you used a brush in a similar color previously, like we did for the cheeks, you can go ahead and use that same color, or that same brush, I should say, for a darker color. So just pick up a little bit of the bright purple, and we're just gonna dust the centers of each of our dark purple flowers. Man, that looks so nice. I hope you can see that. You're getting beautiful, little turtle. And you are mine forever.
I thought you said that was mine. Thank you.
No, you can have it.
Well, I was gonna have it because you said I could have it.
Well, I have my other one.
Yeah, it looks really nice.
I don't know if you can really see the difference in the color in the camera, but here, live in the Crazy Cool Cake Studios, man, it looks gorgeous. Gorgeous. Look at that. A little bit more up here. How beautiful. This one's actually coming out even nicer than the first one.
Thank you.
I'll switch with you. So definitely, if you are making this for a client, you want to recommend they keep it as a keepsake. Not so much because of the non-toxic chalks. They're non-toxic. Nothing's going to happen. But just because of all the hard work that you put into it.
Why wouldn't you just keep it?
I mean, these sugar sculptures last for years and years and years as long as they're out of the sunlight and humidity. Look how cute.
Wow.
I love you, little turtle. Now we're going to just add a little bit of glow in the eyes and he'll be done. I'm going to clean up this mess here. All right, guys, so now we're just going to add the very final touches, which are some really cute little glow dots in his eyes. It represents reflection, and you can use any white gel food coloring you'd like. Today I'm using the Sunny Side Up Bakery white gel food coloring, but you can use any brand at all. It really doesn't matter. So for this, I'm going to use my really cool dotting tools that come in my Bundle Monster, and you can use any two different sizes. So for this, I'm going to use, let's see here. You just want one bigger than the other. So I'll be using two here, a larger ball and a smaller ball. So let me get these out of the way. And then just one dot. Right there, that's all you need. Okay, so just two cute little dots in each eye. I'm gonna use the larger ball for the first dot, top right. Hope you can see that. Boop. Make sure you do the sound effect. And then over here, top right, same side. Boop. Okay. Does that look cute?
Very cute.
Then get your smaller ball tool. Pick up a little dot. And then right underneath. Boop. See how that little dot is a little bit smaller than the first one? Okay, and then another little dot over here. I hope I picked up enough color. Boop. There you go. How does that look?
Looks great.
You like it?
Uh-huh.
So cute. Alright guys, so here is our finished beautiful little turtle, fully decorated using our awesome little flowers from our Wilton Nature Mold. Remember, you can find all the links to all the tools and supplies that we used in this video underneath the video in the description box. So pretty. And he is so much fun to make. I hope you guys have an opportunity to make him. You'll see just how easy it really is. It is a lot of work, but very, very satisfying. And so this is yours, baby.
Thank you, baby, for the turtle.
You're welcome. Let me show you guys the first one I had made. This is mine. So there is our pair of little turtles. Don't they look cute together?
They do.
How beautiful. I love them. All right, guys. Thank you so much for watching our video. Thank you for being subscribers. We really love reading all of your wonderful comments. And please feel free to join us on Facebook. And be sure to also follow us on Instagram. If you like this video, please like and share. And we love you guys. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.
Take care. Bye-bye.